Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner, available for code reviews and on-site training. In this episode, I want to, I want to discuss safely using goto. Now, it seems like we've been taught for a very long time to not use goto in C++. And just for the record, this is not a best practices episode. I am not suggesting that you use goto. But let's just talk about what it means to use goto in C++. All right, now if you saw my episode about goto's are everywhere, and I'll try to remember to put a link to that somewhere in here, maybe a pop-up or something, then you're aware that the compiler is actually generating goto calls in lots of places for you. Like a for loop is effectively a goto. And we can create our own for loop as a goto as well. All right, so we've got a for loop that prints 1 through 10. It looks like I got something wrong now, doesn't it? There we go. I need to increment before doing the check. And we should have 1 through 9 printed in our hand-rolled for loop. So that's, first of all, one reason to not use goto. The constructs that are built into the language are, you know, easier to get right. But you might ask things like, well, what happens if I try to jump to some place where a variable hasn't been created yet? So let's say at the top here, I want to go to start. The compiler complains, jump to label start from here, blah, 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 crosses initialization of int I. So this thing that would have been unsafe to jump over the initialization of I and its allocation on the stack space potentially is flat out forbidden by the compiler. All right, well, let's try something different. So see here, this says a label is defined but not used, and a label is used but not defined. So our labels are actually scoped to functions. There's no way to jump into another function, and there's no way to jump over a variable initialization. So the common things where goto's could cause a problem, undefined behavior, unexpected behavior, they're just simply not allowed in C++. So you could write code like this. This is just going to print the values 1 through 4. And then it's going to go to exit. Now, if you noticed while I was editing this, you can't have a label on an empty statement. The label must mean something. So that's not going to compile. So I have to have an explicit return here, which is fair because main does return a value. But I could just as easily have done an early return from main. Or I could have done a break, or I could have reformatted this code in such a way that whatever other logic I needed actually existed in some other function. So I'm still going to get a compiler failure here because I've got my warnings turned up high enough that I've got labels that are defined but not used, and it doesn't like that. So the question of, can you safely use goto in C++? Yeah, absolutely. The compiler is going to stop you from doing something that is unsafe. Is it a good idea to use goto's in C++? Probably not. There's very rare situations where you might be able to eke out one tiny extra little instruction of savings, but more than likely, if you just refactor the code to have better organization, you don't actually have a need for goto. So this, again, not a best practice. I'm not telling you to go and use goto. I'm just saying, yeah, technically you can safely use it if you want to create harder to maintain code and make your coworkers angry with you. So thanks for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. You know, do the normal things. Be sure to subscribe. Give this video a thumb up if you liked it.